Most credit cards tell you how to earn rewards. They usually have categories that are already predefined and never change. Or for the cards that do change, the bank gives you the calendar and still tells you how to earn rewards. But wouldn't it be great if you could choose your own rewards? Well, now you can. Hey everyone, it's Mark. I'm here to help you put more money in your pocket through credit cards and smart financial habits. If that sounds good to you, then do me a quick favor and click on the like and subscribe button down below. Then be sure to check out the links down below in the description area to apply for a new credit card and to get 2 free stocks from Webull when you open a brand new account and deposit $100 onto your brokerage account. I'd love to know which 2 free stocks you get. Now, most credit cards give you select categories in which to earn rewards, be it points or cash back. For example, you might get 3 points per dollar or 3% cash back in certain categories, then double on something else, and then 1 point per dollar or 1% cash back on all other purchases. But there are some credit cards that actually allow you to choose where you want to earn your rewards. And that can be extremely powerful because let's say you spend money in a certain area at a certain time of the year, then you can be sure to choose the top tier category to maximize that spend for however long it lasts. Then later on, you can switch to a different category if your spending habits change. And one of the best cards allowing you to pick your own rewards is the US Bank Cash Plus Visa Signature Card. It's undergone some plastic surgery over the years with different designs, so perhaps you've seen it look different in the past, but here is the current design right now, and it is a great card to consider having in your wallet if you value cards with no annual fee and cash back in certain categories where you spend a lot of your money. So let's begin with the part that everybody always wants to know about first, the welcome bonus. As of April 2021, you'll be able to earn $150 of cash back after spending $500 in the first 90 days of card membership. You'll also receive a 0% promo APR period for the first 12 months on balance transfers, then it will turn to a variable APR after that. So if you just spend the absolute minimum of $500 in those first 3 months and get $150 of cash back as your reward, that's equal to a 30% return on your spend. And that is phenomenal, especially when you consider that a lot of other cards require you to spend $1,000, $2,000, $3,000 or more in the first 3 months. Now let's dive into the really unique choice style rewards that this card offers. It begins with 5% back in choice categories, and this is how that works. First, you'll choose 2 choice categories in which you'll earn 5% cash back, and you'll earn at that rate for up to $2,000 in combined spend each quarter. So if you exceed that $2,000 threshold, it will then go down to 1% for the remainder of that quarter, after which it will refresh back to 5% for the next quarter. Also be aware that you must enroll each quarter, because if you don't, then you'll only earn 1% for the entire quarter. So make sure to enroll and activate those categories that you hand selected yourself. Next is a 2% everyday category. And once again, you will choose this from a defined list. The cool thing about it though, is that there is no cap or limit on this 2% category. And then that's followed by 1% on all other purchases. When it comes to the annual fee, there is none to worry about on this card. I like $0 annual fees. Now here's a list of the choice and everyday categories directly from US Bank. On the left-hand side in navy blue are the 5% choice categories, and on the right-hand side in the lighter blue color is the list of 2% everyday categories. Now, while there are a handful of other 5% cashback cards on the market right now, usually with those, the bank chooses their own calendar of what you're able to earn in. But US Bank here chose some very unique ones that you don't see on a lot of other cards. Some of the ones that really stand out to me, going from top to bottom, are home utilities, select clothing stores, cell phone providers, electronic stores, gyms and fitness centers, sporting goods stores, furniture stores, and movie theaters. And then moving over to the 2% everyday categories, you choose one of those from the list of gas stations, restaurants, and grocery stores, which are much more common across other card products. So that right there is the number one reason why I love this card so much, and I do have it on my own wait list of cards to get as soon as I'm below 524 because Chase needs me to get some of their cards first. But once I do that, I will be for sure back on the market for this card as well, because I love how US Bank offers a blend of very common categories like gas stations and restaurants with the more uncommon things, and especially because other cards would only earn 1 or 2% at best on those types of categories, where this one gets you 5%. Now, as great as this card is, and by no means do I want to diminish its value whatsoever because it is still a good card, there are some nuances here with several different categories that I want you to be aware of, because when I say, for example, select department stores, that does not mean every department store in the United States. There is a predefined list of those department stores that will earn 5%. So let me go over some of those nuances right now with this visual on the screen that I think will be very beneficial for you. Like I was saying, the 5% select clothing store category is only valid at the ones listed on the screen here. Of course, this list may change over time as new clothing stores are added or other ones decide to terminate their relationship with the US Bank, but nonetheless, this is what is available right now as of early 2021. Then moving down to the second bullet point, the 5% department store category does not include discount stores like Walmart and Target, or wholesale clubs like Costco. And third, the 5% fast food category and the 2% dining category are different. So if you go walk into a restaurant, sit down at a table and have service, that's much more of a dining experience, and you're probably going to earn 2% back on that if you chose restaurants as your everyday category. But then if you go to somewhere like Chipotle or McDonald's for a fast food type of experience, and you've chosen the fast food as your choice category, then you'll earn 5% on those types of locations. And with all of that out of the way, the remaining categories that you can choose from for 5% or 2% really don't have much in the way of additional restrictions. So those are pretty broad and wide open for you to earn a lot of elevated rewards. Speaking of which, let's see how you can redeem these rewards. As a cashback credit card, there are several different ways to redeem the rewards that you've earned, but all of them revolve around the theme of cashback. It starts with a statement credit option, and there is a minimum redemption requirement here of $25. That goes into effect on June 1st, 2021. You can also choose to deposit your cashback to a US Bank checking, savings, or money market account. Again, here, the minimum redemption requirement is also $25 as of June 1st, 2021. Third on the list is a US Bank Visa rewards card that you can use anywhere Visa is accepted. The minimum redemption requirement is still $25, although that has been in effect a little bit longer. And fourth on the list is real-time rewards. This is a super convenient feature where right after you make your purchase, US Bank will send you an automated text asking you if you want to redeem your rewards to cover your charge right on the spot from your mobile phone. The minimum redemption requirement is also a bit lower here at only $10. And that feature still requires enrollment. So if this interests you to be able to redeem on the spot from your phone, make sure that you go into your US Bank online account and turn on real-time rewards. You can also set different thresholds. So for example, if you don't want to receive a text for every single purchase below a certain amount, you can customize that to your liking. This card does come with a couple additional perks and benefits, the first of which is the Visa Signature Concierge. That can be really helpful for securing hard-to-get restaurant reservations, show tickets, and a whole lot more. And then there's the Visa Signature Luxury Hotel Collection, which gives you special perks when you book through the portal, including things like the best available rate guarantee, automatic room upgrades, complimentary Wi-Fi, complimentary breakfast for two, a $25 food or beverage credit, VIP guest status, and late checkout upon request when available. For the insurance and protections, you get zero fraud liability, auto rental collision damage waiver, travel and emergency assistance services, roadside dispatch services, extended warranty protection, warranty manager service, and purchase security. So for a card with no annual fee, this is looking pretty darn powerful, and you can see why I have it on my list of cards that I really want to get. Now, as we bring this video to a close, there are a few things that are really good to know about this card before applying. Check them out here. First of all, your cash rewards will expire at the end of the calendar month, 36 months after the billing cycle in which they were earned. What in the world? Yes, the wording is pretty dense there, but what this means is that unlike the Apple Card, which gives you daily cash almost right after you earn it, the cashback on the US Bank Cash Plus card functions much more like a traditional credit card, where you get your cashback only once per month. And that occurs right after your billing cycle closes. So let's say your billing cycle closes on April 15th. Which will also be the same day that you get your cashback rewards. That means on April 15th, 3 years later, or 36 months later, your cashback rewards will expire. Second, US Bank tends to be sensitive to recent inquiries and newly opened accounts. So it's recommended to avoid applying for other cards for about 6 months before you apply for a card with US Bank. That's not a hard rule, but again, it's just my recommendation to help put the odds of approval more in your favor. Lastly, this card does have foreign transaction fees, so you may not want to use it outside of the US, and it's broken down in the following way. It'll be 2% of each foreign purchase or foreign ATM advance in US dollars, or 3% of each foreign purchase or foreign ATM advance in a foreign currency. But hey, this is not a travel credit card anyway, so the fact that it does have some foreign transaction fees, while still not great, is at least understandable. But more importantly is this question: should you get this card or not? Well, let me help you make a best decision for your situation. You may want to say yes to this card if you prefer cashback over travel rewards, if you want a card with no annual fee, and if you want customizable rewards categories, especially if that means earning 5% cashback in categories that other cards do not offer. However, you'll want to say no to this card if you prefer travel rewards over cashback, if you don't want a card that requires maintenance, that is, activating categories every quarter and keeping track of caps or limits. And lastly, if you're applying for your first credit card, this is usually not a great one to get to start your credit journey. This US bank card that we're talking about works very, very well with any other cashback cards you may have to create basically a full setup. And by using several cards together, it gives you a much more powerful way to get more cashback in your pocket, and even better if these cards all have no annual fee. All that said, if you enjoyed today's video and believe it could benefit others, then please help me get it in front of more people by liking this video, subscribing to the channel, and turning on notifications. Also, a friendly reminder to check out the description area also down below to apply for a new credit card and to get 2 free stocks from Webull when you open a brand new account and deposit $100 onto your brokerage account. I'd love to know which 2 free stocks you get. And do tell me, are you also considering adding this card to your wallet at some point? Or if you already have it, what has your experience been like so far? Let me know down below in the comments. Thank you all so much for watching today's video. I hope it brought you some great value. I'll see you again in future videos. And until then, remember, you are great.